flowers and like scenery, like beach scenery and stuff like that, because it's like more peaceful things. Tattooing was a safety net for me. It helped me, as much as I would move shops because I was so stressed out with the PTSD, and because I had such a gypsy type job, it kind of saved my life, because if I had this anxiety and I had a normal job, I don't think I could hold the job.
And I really want to try to go to those little people conventions, because I really want to know about my short stature and how dwarfism was, you know, started in the first place. And I think by going to those conventions, it will help me learn more about myself. It's good to raise awareness and kind of educate everyone about dwarfism.
Practicing like normal athletes. The money is there. I don't know if the money's there in college yet. I think it's growing. But if these guys are going to practice like athletes, you know, 4 times a week, 4 hours a day, you know, just like a typical basketball or football player.
Oh, shit. Okay, never mind.
Cheers are based on. They could be in the know. I'm sure a lot of them are in those levels, but 90% of scientists are convinced that they live on a ball, right? Because you go to learn astronomy and that's all you learn, and you learn about very detailed things about how the solar system works and how black holes are formed and nebulas and all these things, and there's no way you're ever going to, you know, question the narrative you've been fed basically throughout your master's or PhD, however far they go, they're not gonna question it.
You follow your dreams, you pursue your passions, and I think that if you're doing something that's meaningful to you, then no matter how burnt out you are, you're gonna wanna continue it, and you're gonna wanna keep building it. And if you're at that point where you're just kind of like, oh, I'm not seeing results, or I'm not really getting somewhere, you know, then you just have to push even more, or you have to switch it up. You have to be strategic in whatever you're building.
Basic training, someone does something wrong, it doesn't matter whether it's 1 o'clock in the morning to 4 o'clock in the morning, all you guys are gonna wake up and do PT. That's what the drill sergeants are gonna make you do. There was one time we had a female smack talk one of the drill sergeants, in the middle of the night, mind you. All of us had to sit outside. Well, not all of us, just the females. All the females had to come outside because it was a female who smack-talked the female drill sergeant. The female drill sergeant took us all outside, fucking smoked us for a good hour or so.
My stream has helped them significantly in their lives. It's helped them socialize. It's helped them come to terms with a lot of past trauma. It's helped them learn a lot about themselves, about other people. I have people who tell me I've literally saved their lives because of my stream, because of the words I say. And I never thought that I could be someone like that for anybody. I've had, obviously, friends that I help and that I support in my life, and, you know, but I never thought that I could create such a beautiful community from streaming.
This one hanging up right here. Because in the last 10 years, like, suicide is 56%, which is crazy. And I feel, personally, it's due to social media and expectations on how people are viewed and should live their life and stuff. And, you know, we all want to follow the cool people because it's fun to see the things they do and the expensive things they buy and stuff. It's entertaining.